Last week we were looking at the wonderful invitation that Christ extends to sinners. Come unto me. Today I want us to consider one man who did just that, recorded in the Word of God. In Matthew's Gospel chapter 8, the Lord Jesus has been up on the mountain teaching. And it says when he came down, great multitudes followed him. In other words, this was the time of the Saviour's popularity. Of course, John records later, from that time many of them went back and walked with him no more. They didn't want to follow Jesus because of what it cost to be Christ's disciple. But there the scriptures then turns and says, behold, there came a leper and worshipped Jesus. The scriptures turn away from the crowd and they draw our attention to one man, but he's a leper. There's his pollution. Because a man as a leper was someone who was an outcast. People would shun him. They didn't want to know him, not even his family. He would have to tear his clothes and bare his head and even cry out, unclean, unclean, lest someone would come close to him. But the Bible says this man came and worshipped Jesus. He came to the feet of Christ. I have no doubt whatsoever, whenever the crowd saw him, they would scatter away because they didn't want to be in the presence of a leper. In actual fact, whenever a leper would beg, some people would shun him completely and others would even stone him. But this leper somehow gets through the crowd and falls at the feet of Jesus and worships him. What drives him to the feet of Jesus, friend? His need. He knew that his leprosy was killing him. He was like the walking dead. He was on his way to the grave. And he came to Jesus. The wonderful thing is this man knew his pollution. And yet so many today walk around clothed in their garments of respectability and they do not see that they're sinners. And yet the word of God says in Isaiah chapter 1, from the sole of the foot even unto the head, there is no soundness in it but wounds and bruises and putrefying sores. They have not been closed, neither bound up, neither mollified with ointment. A total, absolute mess of humanity. Sinners from head to toe. And yet they can't see it. Do you? This man did. And it drove him to the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. He got beyond what others would think. And they came to the person, Jesus. And here we says, he cries out, Lord, Lord. You know, he knows that a teacher, he doesn't call him master, a teacher's no good to him. There are many people who know the scriptures, my friend, they're taught in the scriptures, and yet they don't know the Lord. This man knew that the Lord was the only answer, and that's why he came to the person of the Lord Jesus and fell in humility, acknowledging his need at the Saviour's feet. But notice his plea, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. What he's saying to the Lord is this, I place myself not only at your feet, but in your hand. He longs for mercy. He longs to be clean. Tell me, do you long to be saved? Will you cry out, Lord, that I may be clean? But notice the power. He says, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. He knew that the Lord was able to cleanse him. Friend, today I want to tell you, the Lord has power to save you, no matter how deep down in sin you are. Praise God, the Lord can save you and cleanse you from all your sin. But notice the pity. For Mark's gospel says that when Jesus saw him, he was moved with compassion. And he put forth his hand and touched him. Oh, thank God, he's a God ready to pardon. He pities the sinner and is willing to save them. Lastly, notice the performance. Jesus not only touched him, but he said, I will, be thou clean. Thank God today, if you come, he will in no wise cast you out. Heavenly Father, bless your word to our hearts in Jesus' precious name. Amen. From my heart to yours, home to yours. God bless you.